enorme. Sally.
Credit where it is due, for this man came to my aid at my darkest hour. And from what I have heard, I am not the only one. I will pay a great tribute to you in a chronicle of our exploits. But we must first write the end of it. Come.
I see you two have met.
Only briefly. But the night is young, and there is much to discuss. About what you can procure for me.
Our means are limited. But rest assured, I will listen to your needs, Ali. Later. Share what you know about Al-Ghul, so that Bassem may do what he's come here to do.
Yes, yes, yes. Your affairs before mine. But just this once. Al-Ghul sends orders to the prison guards detailing where to dig around Baghdad. But it's not just prisoners he's using.
There is a promissory note for workers here. It looks like Al-Ghul arranges to purchase migrant laborers as well.
Who in Baghdad could make these sorts of arrangements without raising suspicion?
There is but one man, Mas'ud al-Ya'qub. He runs Baghdad's soap mills. Finds paying work for foreign settlers, most of them Persian.
So he forces these laborers into working his dig sites, all under the guise of providing them with a livelihood.
Beshi!
He tracked down one of Al-Ghul's dig sites, posed as a prisoner. What happened?
The search turned up nothing, but that did not stop the guards from trying to silence us. I cracked one skull and fled. I doubt the others were as lucky.
A foolish thing to do with nothing to show for it.
Not nothing. Al-Ghul will be at the Caravanserai. I overheard the guards talking.
Of course. Merchants from all over stop there to rest. If Mas'ud is buying migrant workers, it is likely the Caravanserai is where he conducts his affairs. What does he look like?
He is a large man. Favors adornments like jewels and silks from the east.
Then he will be hard to miss. It is time, Bassem.
What is your plan?
That will be for Bassem to decide.
Bassem? Alone? No. Let me gather some men.
And allow for foolish spectacle. Your day to display your prowess will come. But this day belongs to Bassem. Consider it part of our agreement. Bassem?
I am ready.
Then walk with me. Come, Bassem. Do not stray. Remember. Sanctuary is within our reach, Basim. And like those before and those yet to come, Albu's death will be just. This is a man who preys off the desperate and the disenfranchised. And such atrocities will only continue. For Albu is but a cog in a larger wheel. One that spins destructively. So long as it does, we hidden ones will make it our mission to slow it to a stop. Today, you will lend your hand, your blade, to that very mission. And while Al-Ghul is your first target, he will not be your last. I have great belief in that, and in you. Through all my stoicism, my harsh lessons, know that you have impressed me, Basim. The Order's presence in Baghdad and beyond rests on shifting sands, so long as you remain at the tip of our spear.
And that is where I intend to remain. Beholden to your guidance, Master. As busy as a beehive.
Come, set your sights on the trunk.
Merchants, livestock, caravans from all walks. And I thought Anbar's markets were disorderly.
Where there is disorder, there is chaos. And chaos can bring opportunity. See what avenues present themselves. Be reactive, but patient. And trust your instincts.
That is Mas'ud, on the balcony, just as Ali described.
I see him. Go now. Wet it with the blood of the slain. I will find you when it is over.
You think your cruelty is well hidden, Al-Ghul. For you chose those with little voice, whose cries you knew would go unheard. They dug at your bidding. Died at your hand, and were cast away like so much refuse. All to scour the desert for some artifact. Even now you haggle for flesh, safe in the Karwansarai. You prefer your victims chained and starved. It is time you faced a man unbound.
Come, the stage is yours, Basim. I will be watching.
What see you, my friend?
were promised steady work and fruitful returns. Now we're being made to slog in the desert.
We were deceived.
Please, you must help us.
Tell me what I can do to help.
The man who brought us has a deed that binds us to Mas'ud. If he has not collected his fee, he should still be here.
If I can relieve these men of their duty, it will not be long before Al-Ghul catches wind of his disbanded workforce. This is bad. Nothing can hide from us, Enkidu.
Hey, what? I'll finish you!
As you were. Greetings, my friend. What sorts of goods are you traveling with?
Ivory and honey. And you? Are you seeking to trade?
Perhaps. For now, I will browse for a little longer. fire has caused ruckus and alarm.
Enough of your nonsense.
You off my foot!
Wipe the mouth on you. Show me the path ahead.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Could I interest you in some fruits and vegetables today?
My pomegranates are ripe and succulent.
Is that what you have come to trade? Let me think on it.
Street.
Well met, traveler.
The Karwan Sarai is rich with wares today. I was wondering if you had any goods to sell?
I only deal in dirham. And what I sell are not goods, boy. Though I suppose that depends on who you ask.
I am not sure I understand.
I sell men, laborers. But my lot is spoken for.
Could I change your mind? I have coin to spare, and could use men such as yours.
15,000.
That is absurd. Who has the means to pay so much?
It is better to keep that question to yourself. Be on your way now.
A strange thing to happen upon. Perhaps I can use this to my advantage. If I am going to free those laborers, I will have to steal the deed. Those two men are having a loud dispute, but not loud enough. How might I push them over the edge?
Hey, that's the outlaw they seek! Guard, over here! Hey, look! It's him! Guard, he's over here!
Hold on!
Hey, that's... Pull the water! Don't let him get away!
Where did they go?
Damn, through! Go! That way!
Now to free those men.
The deed! Have I dropped it?
I have claimed the deed from your handler. You are bound no longer. Go! The laborers run amok. Al-Ghul will take notice. I must be ready to strike. Word will surely get to her.
I'll sound your alarm!
All right, I have this. Turn your hate inward, Mas'ud. It is your wickedness that has led you here.
Wickedness? To whom? The unenlightened? The feeble who have cast their lot? It is our divine will to rule over them. Our duty to exact their contribution.
Contribution? To what?
To what could be. The very knowledge of which lies buried beneath these sands.
Some things are meant to stay that way.
No, 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 no. These are gifts, destined to be recovered. They speak to us, as you well know.
Me?
Oh, yes. A hidden one you may be, but not just.
clear your mind. Al-Ghul's relentless pursuit at the expense of human lives has come to an end. It is a day of victory, not only for those spared of his cruelty, but for the Hidden Ones. The Order's grand plot in Baghdad may still be a mystery, but we can at least be certain Al-Ghul's role in it has been vanquished.
I believe what he sought to uncover were more strange objects. Like the one I took from the Winter Palace. What does the Order want with these relics of the past? And why guard them with so much effort?
You are beginning to ask the right questions, Basim. We shall find the answers together.
Lately, all I have are questions.
What do you mean?
Nothing. Forget I said anything.
How am I to guide you if you will not speak openly?
I have struggled with nightmares. In these dreams, a djinni torments me until I wake up panicked and soaked with sweat. In Alamut, I had nearly forgotten about it. But when I killed Al-Ghul, I felt its presence again. And I am left asking why. Why here? Why now? Why me? Piling questions and no answers. I meant to tell you, but...
You were afraid I would think you weak of mind. We are only as weak as we allow ourselves to be. To shed a weakness, you must do what is necessary to mend that which causes you pain.
Will you permit me a brief respite? I wish to seek out an old friend.
Nihal? I remember. She is important to you, isn't she?
She is. But last we spoke, I led her to believe otherwise.
This causes you pain. Then go and heal this wound without delay. Find me at the Harbiya Bureau when it is settled.
If that was indeed Nihal, I have not a clue where she went. Back home in Anbar, maybe.
Allah!
What? Won't take long! Ha!